watching the latest news from FinancialMirror.tv. European leaders are calling for unprecedented levels of global coordination to tackle the financial crisis that continues to hit share prices around the world. The economic turmoil will be the focus of a two-day, 43-nation Asia-Europe meeting, which opens Friday in Beijing, according to European Union President José Manuel Barroso. Leaders hope this week's summit in China will help bring agreement on a response to the crisis ahead of a November 15th meeting hosted by U.S. President George W. Bush in Washington. Barroso outlined no specific proposals, but said a solution needed to be based on transparency, responsibility, cross-border supervision, and global governance. He also said the world's financial system needed major reform. Sweden and New Zealand responded to the global financial crisis by cutting interest rates by 50 basis points and a record 1 percentage point, respectively, on Thursday. Weak Japanese exports prompted worries that the world's second biggest economy is heading into recession. Bank of England Governor Mervyn King said Britain, too, was ready to lower interest rates again after warning this week the country was probably entering the first recession in 16 years. Central banks around the world are trying to limit the economic damage from the worst financial crisis since the Great Depression of the 1930s. U.S. foreclosure filings increased 71% in the third quarter from a year earlier to the highest on record as home prices fell and stricter mortgage standards made it harder for homeowners to sell or refinance. More than 765,000 U.S. properties either got a default notice, were warned of a pending auction, or were foreclosed in the quarter, the most since records began in January 2005. The worst U.S. housing slump since the 1930s is being compounded by a recession that began in the third quarter and may last a year or more. Home prices in 20 U.S. metropolitan areas fell in July at the fastest pace on record, and sales of previously owned homes in August were 32% below the peak reached in September 2005. OPEC ministers, anxious to arrest a deep oil price slide and cushion a bruised world economy, gathered in Vienna on Thursday ahead of emergency talks. International benchmark U.S. crude has slumped by more than 50% from a record high of $147.27 hit in July. On Thursday, it was trading below $68 per barrel. The plunge prompted OPEC to bring forward to Friday an emergency meeting originally set for November 18. As the economic slowdown has destroyed demand for oil and stocks have increased, most OPEC ministers have said a supply cut ranging from 1 to 2 million barrels a day was essential. But leading exporter Saudi Arabia has yet to comment publicly. The producer group's lack of discipline helped to push oil to below $10 during the Asian economic downturn in the late 1990s. European stocks fell for a third day amid the global gloom, while U.S. index futures and Asian shares declined. The London Interbank Offered Rate for three-month loans in dollars was little changed at 3.5%. The overnight rate rose for the first time in 10 days, climbing 9 basis points to 1.21%. The cost of protecting corporate bonds from default surged to a record on concern that Argentina and Pakistan may default, worsening global economic turmoil. Borrowing costs for developing nations jumped as Belarus joined governments seeking a bailout from the International Monetary Fund to weather the credit crisis. UK retail sales fell in September as rising unemployment and the specter of a recession prompted British shoppers to curb spending. In France, business confidence slumped to the lowest in almost 15 years as the global credit crisis worsened, threatening to deepen a likely recession in the euro region's second largest economy. Meanwhile, Goldman Sachs plans to cut about 3,200 jobs. That represents about 10% of the total staff of the New York-based bank. Amazon said sales in the holiday quarter would fall short of Wall Street expectations, sending its shares down nearly 14% as consumers cut back on spending and a strengthening U.S. dollar eroded the value of foreign sales. Wall Street was already spooked when online auctioneer eBay cut its forecast last week, predicting a weak holiday season due to softness in consumer spending. Forrester Research predicted in a report released on Tuesday that holiday spending would grow 12% this year over 2007, compared with 18% growth in the last season. Daimler, Hyundai Motor, and Fiat added to the gloom facing the auto sectors with bleak forecasts for next year as the global financial crisis took its toll. The news from Europe and Asia came as Chrysler cut production. Germany's Daimler, maker of Mercedes-Benz luxury cars and heavy trucks, lowered its expectations for the year, adding that all of its forecasts had a high degree of uncertainty to them. Italy's Fiat said global demand for its products could drop 10 to 20%, and its profit may tumble by as much as 65% in a worst-case scenario. Global carmakers face a sharp drop in sales as drivers put off major purchases on fears of a recession and the cost, if not the lack, of getting loans. Thank you for watching FinancialMirror.tv.